Hey everyone, Dan Lotz here, director of Watch Me As I Go. Here's a quick little introduction before the feature film plays. There'll be a little time code to skip this. But basically, I want to talk to you about a few things. Watch Me As I Go was a feature film I made with my wife on vacation in Myrtle Beach. It was a very low budget, DIY, kind of put together on the fly. It was a lot of fun. Me and my wife were really, really excited to put it together. And it was really fun to take my wife into the process of making a feature film. Beyond that, I wanted to talk about a little bit of promotion. With indie films, it's very hard to get promotion, especially on the DIY sort of side of indie film. So the best ways you can help promote this are three things: like, comment, and share. Liking. First of all, if you're going to watch the film and you know you're going to like it or you're a fan of this channel, hit the like button right away. If you're a fan of indie film and you just want to support an indie filmmaker, more likes equals more engagement, which equals better placement on YouTube. And finally, if you know you're going to watch the film later and you might like it, hit the like button. Again, that initial engagement is so critical. Second of all, commenting. Commenting is super important because it's telling the YouTube algorithm that people are engaging and enjoying the material that they're watching. So if you have a comment while you're watching the film, put the time code and make a little funny comment about it, and then leave a review at the end of the film on YouTube or Letterboxd as well. Those are two places that can help us really get the word out about Watch Me As I Go. And finally, sharing it. If you enjoy this film or you want to support indie film, share it on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, basically any platform you're allowed to. Put the link on there. That would be really helpful. So I hope those are just some good guidelines that will help you help indie filmmakers out. I think that we need the help, and anything we can do, we are very gracious and grateful for. So without further ado, enjoy the film and have a good time.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Weezer with their song, You Gave Your Love to Me Softly. Bit of an underrated gem there, B-side to El Scorcho from 1996, also on the 1995 Angus soundtrack. You probably heard it there. Just a reminder, by the way, tomorrow night, Pier 109, Dave's Underground Rave. Doors at 6 p.m., photo opportunity with Dave the Raver. You love him here, so go and see him there. 6 p.m., Pier 109, Dave's Underground Rave. You're listening to 929 The Lion. It's the Bobby Boy Hour. Coming up next, going back to 1967, The Kinks, Waterloo Sunset. 929 The Lion.
Shine so bright, but I don't need no friend. As long as I gaze on Waterloo sunset, I am in paradise. Every day I look at the world from my window. so lazy, don't want to wander. I stay at home at night, but I don't feel
afraid. Did the hotel tell you what happened? Fuck. I'm Dan, by the way. I know we're not gonna be talking for very long, but yeah. It's nice out, though.
Hello, thank you for calling Winston Terrace, Oak Point. How can I help you?
Hi, basically I have a situation where, me and another person just got booked in the same...
Yes, great, great, great. Can I get the last name, please?
Thomas, Daniel Thomas.
No, just the last name, please.
Thomas.
Ah, Mr. Thomas. Yes, 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 let me look it up. Yes, yes, yes. 10th floor, king size bed. What can I do for you, Mr. Thomas? What's the issue?
Basically, I was booked in a room with a Mrs. Thomas that is not related to me. We got booked in the same room.
I only see your name on the room, so you may bring anyone you want to bring in your room. You can bring anything, a dog, a rat, a mouse. Do you have a pet mouse?
No, I just need...
ribs? French fry? I do not discriminate, Mr. Thomas.
I need, very simply, for us to have separate rooms. We paid for separate rooms.
Mr. Thomas, come on. You know we'd have no more rooms.
So you're telling me I'm going to have to stay here, in this room, with her?
Oh, maybe she take room. Maybe you can strip her for the night.
You don't mind if I stay here? It's just a couple nights. It's a crappy situation, I understand. I'm not happy about it. This was supposed to be for me. Just a trip by myself. But what are we gonna do? I mean, they said that they're not gonna give us anything. I mean, basically, it's either go home or go sleep in some shitty motel. So why don't we just try to make this work? Like, maybe you take the bed, I'll take the couch, we'll just stick apart for that, but maybe we could, like, hang out. I know you're not here with anyone, I'm not here with anyone. I think it would be a great idea if we just went out for dinner, drinks, maybe got to know each other, maybe we make friends, maybe we're friends.
I'm not really interested in making friends with you. Yes, this is a shitty situation. I'm a good person. I'm not gonna, like, kick you out on the street, but I don't have to be friends with you and hang out with you. Like, I came here by myself. Like, this is supposed to be my vacation, not hang out with some random dude I don't even know. You can do whatever you want. You have a key to the room. I'm gonna go lay down and take a nap. Feel free to do whatever the hell you want. I don't care.
Thank you.
Okay, so your little fucking voyeur over here.
I'm not a voyeur. I like the people watch. There were cops. There's some dude with a dog that only has three legs.
Yeah, that's pretty fucking weird.
It's just interesting.
That's
not a voyeur. I'm just a...
That's what's great about the scenario, is that we could meet two very interesting people. You and me, we could be hanging out and learning about each other for a couple days.
You think you're interesting?
I think I'm pretty interesting. I mean, my friends say I'm interesting, I guess. I'm not saying I'm fucking, you know, David Bowie or anything like that. I'm not some international superstar. But, like, come on. I think I'm okay.
You're not going to leave me alone until I, like, give in to you, are you?
It's not about giving in. It's about trying to make this enjoyable. Because we're booked in the same room, so we really can't make this work unless we're both going to be chill and cool about this. Instead of just trying to fight and argue and, like, whine in the bed, I think it would be much more fun if we just decided, hey, let's have a good time, and we can make this a very, very interesting situation.
This is a weird, fucked up situation.
Yes, it is very weird. It is very fucked up, but overall, I had an idea. I was sitting there, laying awake, and I was thinking it would be really awesome. There's a bar downstairs when I came up on the lobby, and I was thinking maybe if I bought you just two drinks, and I got two drinks, it would be a lot of fun, and if things don't work out and you don't like me after that, I'd just go away. Like, I would literally just take my car and leave and go home. It would be fucking sad.
Okay. Here's the deal. I'll go down to the bar with you, but I want something else in return. I want another favor.
Okay.
Nothing sexual, so don't get that in your little head.
I didn't say that. So let's get that drink.
Okay. Maybe.
Just like anyone else, you just gotta talk to her, be nice to her. You gotta snap out of it. Just talk about your dad, talk about anything. Anything that's interesting. That's it. That's all you gotta do. Just talk interesting things. It's not a formula. It's not complicated.
Oh my gosh.
What?
There's that that guy.
The one from the bar last night?
Yeah, exactly.
That guy was an idiot.
He is out of his mind, stoned. He's taking off his clothes.
You mean his bathing suit too?
Look at
him. He's, oh my God, he's on the beach naked.
Yeah.
He's gotta be like high on drugs or something.
Yeah, it looks like it.
I wonder how long that naked guy's gonna stay in jail for.
Yeah, they have a pretty strict law about, even like, if you're wearing like a thong, I think they just changed it. You literally get arrested. There's some people that get arrested for having thongs here. But I think they just changed it, so yeah, they're pretty strict about that. I don't think they're gonna let him just run around naked.
It's pretty crazy.
So have you ever been here before?
A long time ago when I was a kid.
Yeah, I went here with a couple buddies. It was pretty fun, but I don't know. I think I needed to do it for real, like nightlife, come out here by myself. You can't really experience it without I don't know. I feel like you're going with your buddies. You're going to be acting a little bit different.
Right. Well, then you're also stuck to whatever they want to do. Again?
Yeah, that person was doing that weird puking noise.
It's like the third time.
Yeah, I don't know what the hell that's about. That's just weird. But.
Did you see the cactus?
Yeah, I did see the cactus.
I didn't know there were cactuses here.
No, I didn't either. So, are you more of a beach person or like a sit and relax person?
Probably a sit and relax kind of person.
You don't want to get, like, sand everywhere.
Yeah.
I like to roll around in the sand, kind of get all dirty.
Dirty Dan.
Yep, exactly. Looks like there's no lifeguard on duty today, so I guess you just drowned in the water.
Maybe you had to go to the bathroom or something.
Who watches the waters when the lifeguard has to go to the bathroom?
I don't know. I mean, it's not peak season. There's not a lot of people in the water. It should be fine.
Just a bunch of little kids ready to drown. That's all.
Stop. That's horrible.
Look at them. They're all over there. They're running away. You gotta watch out.
I almost drowned once. Twice.
Really?
Yeah.
When?
When I was a really little kid. And then once when I was like 9 or 10.
I have a really funny story.
What?
Basically, when I was a kid, I had a friend who was this little snitch, and I squirted him with a squirt gun because we were playing with squirt guns. And this kid tried to say that I tried to drown him, and he showed his mom. He dunked me under the water, and he showed the mom, and I was like, "Mom, I literally squirted him with a squirt gun," and it was.
Your mom believed you?
Yeah, my mom believed me, totally. And she knew I wasn't a liar. I mean, I was, just not for that. But it was pretty funny. And ever since then, I never hung out with that guy ever again.
Rightfully so.
That's pretty pretty shitty. What are you laughing about?
What?
I'm trying to tell a story here and you're laughing.
Sorry.
Yeah, my dad. He had this big boat, and my mom made him sell it. And I know for a fact, if he just came down here for just even a week, he would go crazy with how many boats there are, the fishing. I mean, remember when we saw that guy? He was like catching like 10, what was it, like bass, or I don't even know what's out here.
I have no clue.
I'm not a fishing aficionado.
Aficionado.
Yeah. But... What about palm trees? I thought palm trees were like only like a Hawaii, like West Coast type thing. I didn't know that. I genuinely didn't know that.
No. Florida and California have them as well. Nevada.
That makes
Those
sense.
Those are the only places I've been that I've seen palm trees.
Nevada has palm trees?
Yeah.
I thought they only had cactuses. Like that was like the main thing that you see out there is cactuses and...
No, they have palm trees.
You've been out there in Nevada. Is it like really, really dry out there? I heard it's like the climate is just crazy.
Yeah, it's not bad. I like it. I like warm places.
So what's your favorite place in the whole world if you could go anywhere?
Florida.
Okay, why Florida?
I don't know, I just like it there.
So, you're not one of those people that loves Disney and goes to the parks and does all that stuff?
No. That's so nerdy. Never.
You serious? You don't, like, watch, like, Disney movies?
No, do you?
No, it's not that I, like, watch them, but, I mean, when I was a kid, I mean, like, Mulan. Like...
All right, I love Disney, okay?
I okay.
love Disney, all right? I don't tell people that, though.
Why?
Because it's kind of nerdy.
It's not, like, crazy nerdy.
A little bit.
Well, what about Star Wars? You like Star Wars? Is that a thing you like?
Not really.
Oh, okay. Well, it was nice talking to you. Just joking.
So, your last name is Thomas?
Yeah. Not originally. I'm divorced.
Divorced, like how long ago?
Like 2 years ago?
Yeah. What happened?
I don't really want to talk about it. He was just a bad guy.
Not a guy you'd take to Myrtle Beach?
No. Definitely not.
What are you like looking for something else?
That's kind of personal.
Okay.
I mean, well, isn't everyone?
I don't know. Some people like being single. I mean, what, Bill Gates now just broke off with his wife, so I guess some people like being single. But, I don't know. I think most people want to make it work, if they can.
Right. Do you like dogs?
Do I like dogs? I mean, why are you deflecting?
Sorry.
I know you're like trying to.
I mean, I just met you. I don't want to tell you everything.
Okay. I thought we had something like you were talking and getting to know each other and we. I don't know. I just thought that was different. I didn't know you were divorced. You didn't tell me you were divorced.
Well, I don't broadcast that out to everyone. I'm a pretty private person. That dog is cute, though. Just saying.
Okay. I agree. He's pretty damn cute. He's a nice dog. Good boy. I just wish you would, like, let your walls down a little bit. I mean, we're going to be here for a couple of days. I'm going to be leaving soon. And
well, what do you want to know?
Like... Do you like me? Like, do you like hanging out with me, or am I just like some annoying guy?
No, I like you. I like hanging out with you. I mean, if I didn't like hanging out with you, you wouldn't be here right now.
I thought I was the one tagging along. I thought I was like pissing you off, but I guess not.
Yeah.
See that jellyfish over there?
I did. I've never seen a jellyfish before. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, I haven't either. Maybe like in like an aquarium or something like that, but we're doing it again.
Deflecting?
Doing this small talk bullshit. You know, we've done that all day. It's been fun. We've done it for the last couple days. It's been good.
Is that better?
Yeah, that was a lot better.
You smell so fucking good.
Thank you. Eagles.
Whales.
Eagles.
Whales.
Eagles.
I wonder if other people do that when they see these stores, the eagles and the whales stores. I wonder if they go eagles and whales. I mean, what else did we see? Was there other ones that had one?
don't think animals.
But there was other ones that had just singular words that just mean nothing, wasn't there?
Yeah.
Like which ones? I'm trying to remember now. There was peaches, eagles, whales.
Giants.
Giants? Like, what does giants mean? When you go in there, are you expecting big clothes or?
I don't know.
It's pretty weird. Isn't it kind of like fun just to watch people like as if they're like little tiny ants? You can go like this and go. I don't know. Sunset is so amazing.
It's very pretty. Yeah, very beautiful.
Yep, it is pretty beautiful. I think the most fun stuff though is just like, I don't know, looking at everyone just kind of like. It's like an ecosystem. It's like a little ant farm. You just see everyone around and everyone's doing their little thing. I try to like look around. Wish we had your binoculars. Just look down and I don't know, spy on people. I try to find anyone who's like doing something criminal, something bad. What about you? Or just for the fun?
Yeah.
So mine's much more nefarious. I'm like looking for people. Last night, there was a guy and he was going down with his car and the guy had walked up to a car. He checked it out. Some other person's car. He had just pulled in. Then he pulled out left. And then another guy came in and what he did was he went up to a random car. It looked like he had never met. He went through the passenger side, stuck his hand in and grabbed a big bag of something, and then he handed him something. I saw it. It was crazy. It was
so like a
drug deal or
something.
Nudie movies or something. No, not that. Maybe he was going to take all that money that he made from that deal and go to Eagles. Yeah, have a sip of that. Looks good. What is it?
Vodka cran.
I won't drink all of it. So, what would you say is the best thing in Myrtle Beach? Like, the best part of it? Like, why you'd come back?
The beach.
The beach?
Yeah. I like swimming at the beach.
Yeah. I wish it was a little bit warmer, but I feel like once it hits, like, July... ish. It's gonna be super fucking hot, but it will be way more cozy to swim in and do all that kind of stuff.
I'm afraid of jellyfish, though. I saw three of them.
That's so weird. How did you end up seeing three jellyfish in one beach? At like one strip of just...
Well, it was two different days, but yeah, I saw three jellyfish.
That's crazy. Jellyfish. Do you think they were alive or do you think they were dead? Like, did they look?
I think they were alive.
That sounds so miserable, being like crisping to death. They're literally just sitting there. Like, I wonder if anyone that feels ballsy enough to like get a stick and put them back in the water. You know how like you see a bird with like its wing, like hurt or injured. And then you're like, oh, I should like nurse it. I know my mom used to do that. We would ever get up if we ever had a bird, a baby bird that would like fall down, we would like try to like nurse it back to health. And obviously they always die because once you do that, it's, I don't know, it just ruins the ecosystem, I guess. So did you have a fun time with me?
Yeah.
Good trip?
Yeah.
A lot better than you thought, really?
For sure.
If you had to give me a Yelp review, like what kind of review would you give me? Like, what would you say? What would be the negatives? What would be the positives?
You snore.
I snore. I thought you were gonna say I smell, and I was gonna get real mad there.
One star.
One star. Come on.
you wouldn't go on the Ferris wheel with me. One star.
One star.
You were
okay.
Scared.
My review, 5 stars out of 5. I think that's how Yelp does it. Maybe they do it out of 10. If it's out of 10, then you're screwed. But five out of five.
All right, I give you 4.5. You did have to weasel your way in a little bit.
There we go. That's it. That's the sunrise right there. That's it.
You mean the sunset?
Sunset. You know what I mean. I blew it there.
Yeah, a little bit. It's okay.
Are you upset at me or something?
No. Not at all. I don't know why you think that. I'm having a great time.
Hey.
What?
Are you going to say what you're feeling? Because I know you're... whole demeanor has just changed.
I quit. I'm not playing anymore. You've already beat me 3 times anyway.
I'm sorry. It looks like it's gonna storm.
Yeah.
Do they get tornadoes out here? You know?
No, they get hurricanes.
Oh. So if you get hurricanes, you don't get tornadoes?
I don't know. I'm not a meteorologist. I have no idea.
I don't know. Well, where you live, where you come from, do they get tornadoes?
Yes.
Where you come from?
That's where I come from.
Where do you come from? Are you an alien? What planet are you from?
Yay.
What state are you from? That's what I'm trying to ask you.
I already told you.
Which was?
Ohio.
Oh, yeah. I already forgot.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
Once you say Ohio, you just go...
Dude.
I'm just being funny. I'm being funny. I mean, I'm from a shitty part of Illinois. It's a small area, so it's not any more hopping or anything like that.
Excuse me.
You okay there?
Yeah.
This area looks clear.
Yeah, that's weird.
One time, I was driving my car, and I was outrunning the storm. This is a real story. Basically, I was driving, and the clouds were following me, so the back half of my car was getting wet, and the front half of my car was dry.
That's crazy.
So where are you taking me?
Oh, shoot. Did you see that?
Yeah, we almost died.
We did not almost die.
It seems that, my time was then.
Shut up.
Could you imagine if our families found us and then they're like, oh, who's this weird random lady that, or man that, yeah, that would be strange. They think we have this whole secret life. You were my mistress. Because I'm married, obviously.
You are?
No, I'm just joking. I had to be funny. So, why were you all, like, crabby at the card game? You seemed really upset.
I don't know what to say.
Okay, how about you just say... what's on your mind? That's a good start.
I don't want to talk about it.
Okay. That's fine with me. But you have to pay the bridge troll. And that is, you have to tell me where we are going.
It's a surprise.
Then you have to tell me your feelings.
Yeah, that's not happening either.
Okay. Want some?
No.
Okay. And then I guess we're just gonna play the quiet game.
You know, silence isn't a bad thing.
This is not an easy message to send. I've been thinking about it like a billion times. This is like a trip you can never forget about. Just every little thing, the smells, sounds. Way you are laying in bed. But I'd be lying if I said that I have to get back to real life and I can't just stay here forever. And I'm just not very good with looking things right in the eye, how they are. I like to just, I don't know, just maybe look to the side of them, not just really look at them how they are, but how I want them to be. And I don't really want to make this hard on you. Maybe it's not, maybe you don't even really care that much, but I don't know, I think you do. And I just want to say that I'm glad this all happened and that I'd do it all over again just to hear your voice. So that's fucking stupid, but yeah, you'll probably get this when you wake up, and by that point I'll have blocked your phone. So
I'm not good at this shit. I don't make relationships this complicated. I was running it over in my brain 100 times. And I was thinking, oh, we could text, we could call, we could do the long distance thing, it could work. It works. I've looked at it, people have done it. But it's just going to be complicated and confusing, and it's going to just soil every great memory that we had here, and it was great. So what I was thinking is, why don't you watch me as I go? Would you do that? Well, I'm gonna go, okay?
So dry, but I don't.